Hey, Ignite Church, my Christian brothers and sisters, man, it's good to be meeting with you again. I hope that this week has been an incredible one as we're continuing to walk through this really crazy time. I'm excited. This is the first of kind of a new series of devotions. I hope that you guys have been blessed by the content that as a church we've been putting out. Easter was incredible for us. And in this really, really inconsistent and weird season, it kind of was an anchor point for us. And so now we're on the other side of it. And we get to share some new stuff, looking forward to summer. And so thanks for spending a moment with you. Go ahead and pull out your Bibles because we're not going to do too much pre-talking today. I just want to jump into one of my favorite stories with you. And so I was kind of given an opportunity today to just like, Jason, you can share any story you want. You can kind of speak any word you want. And this is a story that I've shared from the stage innumerable times. And so if you're an Igniter, like you've heard this a lot, but it legitimately is one of my absolute, absolute favorite Old Testament stories. It's one you don't hear a lot, which breaks my heart because it's so powerful, but it's found in 2 Kings chapter 6, and particularly the story is verses 15 through 23, and it's a story of Elijah. And if you don't know much about him as a prophet of God, he was an absolutely incredible man of faith, one of the most spirit-filled and miracle-filled people of the Old Testament by far. Moses is right there with him, but when you talk about just the quantity of miracles that this man performed, there aren't very many people in the Old Testament scriptures that are like him, which is to me is an illustration of the fact that this guy just really walked with the will and the heart of God, directing his steps and directing his actions. And in this particular case, to give you some context for the verses you're about to look at and read, Elijah was aiding the king of Israel as they were combating a common enemy in Syria. Syria is one of those enemies, kind of like the Philistines or the Moabites, that every so often it just shows up over and over and over again to really torment the people of Israel. And in this particular period of time, the king of Syria was extremely frustrated because anytime he would move militarily against Israel, it was like, if you want to read the story for yourself, the way that his advisors speak, it's as though someone is in his own bedchamber. Like people, it's like the Israelites know the plans before things are even happening. And this is happening through the prophet Elijah, where God is bringing a revelation to Elijah about what this enemy's doing. And Elijah is going to the king of Israel and to the soldiers and letting them know what's going on. And so again, our God is giving great victory, kind of tying into the things I was talking about before Easter. He's illustrating his majesty and his control. Even the greatest nation is not greater than him. And so long story short, the king of Syria is very angry at Elijah. And so finally, he gets irritated enough at Elijah that he says, you know, I'm sending the army not against Israel. I'm sending my army against Elijah. I'm trying to capture Elijah. Because it kind of just feels like, well, if we can capture Elijah, then it's kind of like capturing all of Israel. And just before we move on to the actual story, think about the power of that for a second. You know, one man, one woman of God, filled with his spirit and trusting in his power, is greater than the whole army of an enemy nation. Like this foreign king, I think, kind of had it right. Like it'd be better to get Elijah than anyone else because of his connection to God. So the story kind of begins with Elijah's servant getting up and going out to begin the day. And when he gets up and walks out of Elijah's little house, he sees that the hills are filled with enemy soldiers. And you take a second and imagine what would it be like to, you know, wake up, rub the sleep out of your eye, and see that there's enemies as far as your eyes can see, thousands and thousands of enemies coming against you to conquer you. And so this servant does what any of us would do. He freaks out. And that's exactly what we would do. And don't any of you on the internet say you do anything other than freak out. You have thousands of men with swords bared running at you. It's a good time to freak out. So he runs back inside. Elijah, we're going to die. And Elijah very nonchalantly says some of the most powerful words in the Old Testament, maybe in the scriptures. He says, don't worry, because there are more for us than against us. And he says it so casually in this story, like, don't worry about it. There's more for us than against us. And the servant, of course, is very confused because he's seeing with his physical eyes the way that most of us do most of the time. And Elijah prays to God and says, let him see. Let him see the truth. Let him see into the spiritual. And guys, there's not enough time for me to dive into the depth of that. But there's a part of me that wonders, like, how often was Elijah looking with eyes that could see more than what physical eyes could see? Because it seems like this is a very common easy, natural state of being for Elijah. But your Lord, let him have a glimpse. And it says that when the servant looks out, he sees that around all these innumerable soldiers are even more innumerable angels with swords of fire. The reason why I share this story is that I think that there are so many of us in this time that we feel surrounded. And I'm not just talking about COVID. I mean, we were very blessed that the immediate, emergent priority threat of that seems to be decreasing in our nation, in our world. And thank you, Jesus, for that. But some of you, you still feel surrounded because there's not enough provision and you're worried about your finances. There's not enough time to meet all the needs you have. There's not enough space in your house. There's not enough of whatever. And you feel really surrounded by enemies. And I just wanted to remind you that it is truth that there is more for you than against you. And if we had eyes to see, there are more angels surrounding you in your house. There are more angelic protectors around your children. Our God is the God who already sees the future of your career, and you have nothing to worry about, because at the word of the prophet, those thousands of enemies that seem so threatening, they can be blinded and led by the hand to the King of Israel. And I just want you to know that whatever your enemy is, our God, he's triumphant over it. He's powerful and he's present in the midst of it. And at a word, he can immediately take control and change your situation. So trust in him, rely on him, pray to him, believe in him. And I'm hoping that this week, some of you will have eyes to see the power of God that surrounds us and, even better, surrounds our enemies. Love you guys. I hope you're doing incredible. And I can't wait to bring another little snippet from God's word to talk through with you soon. Be blessed and we'll see you soon.